Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I have a little bit of a different vlog style intro because the video you are about to see was filmed 3 or 4 weeks ago and I cannot figure out what I did with the intro footage. So I'm just doing a really quick refilm of the intro here. But for today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys what is in my makeup artist kit, but most importantly, focusing on the affordable basics and staples that I think a lot of you guys will find useful and helpful if you are an up and coming makeup artist or you're thinking about being a makeup artist and you want really budget-friendly options to start building your kit and stuff like that. I have a lot of those in my collection that I want to share with you guys today. Before we get started, I do just want to say that I'm not certified. I'm not claiming to be a professional makeup artist, and I don't have this huge, fancy, expensive kit with like extensive shade ranges and extensive products. I have a very low budget when it comes to building my kit and buying products for it, and I don't really have a large clientele either. Being a freelance makeup artist for me is definitely more of a side thing, more of a love and a passion and a hobby. I love applying makeup on other people. I love making other people feel beautiful and really just educating them about the process. And I definitely don't think that you guys need to spend an arm and a leg on makeup products to do so. I definitely know that supplies can be expensive. I know that it even took me a while to accumulate what I have now, and I would consider all of this to be pretty affordable, but I'm just gonna show you guys all of that today. I feel like this could be really helpful. I definitely wish that I found a video like this when I was trying to start my kit, when I was interested in becoming a makeup artist and really gathering supplies to actively do makeup on other people. So I'm gonna be taking you guys through my makeup artist kit drawer today. I'm gonna be telling you my absolute favorite products that I think are really great affordable basics, from concealers, disposable applicators, sanitary products, stuff to clean your makeup, a few like beginner makeup pieces here and there. We're gonna cover all of that today. So I really hope that you guys enjoy seeing this video and find it helpful. If you guys are fellow makeup artists and you have any other recommendations, definitely make sure to leave them down below because I'm always looking for ways to kind of grow my kit on a budget and I would love to hear from you. So I really hope that you guys enjoy and let's just go ahead and get started. One of the first things that I have in my kit that I want to show you guys are lashes. I think lashes are really important because a lot of the times clients will like lashes. Typically when someone is getting their makeup done, they kind of just want to go all out and do the lashes as well. So my favorite lashes to keep in my kit are the Ardell Demi Wispies because these are very, very affordable. You get 5 pairs of lashes for $10, which I think is a steal. $2 per pair of lash is not bad, and the Ardell Wispies are some of my favorites. I also have some Demi Wispies in here. Individual lashes by Kiss are really great if you guys are a little bit uneasy on how to apply a strip lash. Those are really nice. And then I also just have some thicker lashes if my clients want something a little bit more like Va Va Voom and out there. These are from Dita Mora Lash, and then these are House of Lashes Boudoir Lashes. On the side right here, I don't know if you guys can see, I also have some more like luxurious fluffy lashes. These are the Ilore Luxe Cashmere Lashes. I have some more Kiss Lashes. These are their Naked Drama Lashes in Chiffon. And then I also have the Kiss Triple Push-Up Collection in Brassiere. So just some more intense lashes. Typically for me and the clientele around my area, an intense lash isn't always wanted and typically isn't always requested. I find that the Ardell Wispies or the Demi Wispies are typically a little bit more popular. These are also going to be more affordable. Just definitely look out for lashes in value packs like this. I have even seen really great lashes in packs like this in like TJ Maxx or Marshalls. For lash glue and applicators, I have a couple of different ones. My favorite lash glue ever, this is the one for my kit. I have a separate one for myself. This is the Duo Brush On Adhesive. This is the latex free one. I really like this because you never know who has a sensitivity to latex. I personally kind of do have a sensitivity to latex, so I just think it's always better to be safe than sorry. The latex free is really nice, and if you guys can see, this has a little brush on tip which makes it really easy to apply to the lashes and control how much product you're using. Another eyelash adhesive that I have is the Duo one again, but this is the dark tone. This one I would say is a little bit more heavy duty than the brush on one because it does have latex in it. But again, if you are using latex products, I would just double check that the person isn't allergic or doesn't have a sensitivity. And I personally find it the easiest to apply lashes on other people with tweezers, so I just have a few different ones here. So that is what I have in my kit when it comes to lashes. Like I said, just have a nice mix of natural and dramatic. I would say most times, at least around me, clients go for the more natural lashes or even something like the individuals are really nice, but you never know, so I have a mix of everything. Next in my makeup artist kit, I have concealers, and these LA Girl Pro concealers are incredible. I know there was like a meme going around Twitter at one point saying like, oh, girls have this and call themselves makeup artists. I don't understand that meme because I think these concealers are so great. They come in an amazing array of shades and they are so affordable. Like I said, especially if you are building your kit, you do not need to have every single shade of Tarte Shape Tape, of the Too Faced concealer. That is going to be absolutely insane when these are like $2 or $3 a piece and they work so, so great. I also personally use this concealer on myself. A lot of the stuff in this drawer is stuff that I've used myself and love so much that I wanted to get for my kit, but this LA Girl Pro concealer is really great. It has that perfect amount of coverage. It's really creamy, really great for all skin types. It's not going to run off oily skin, but it's not going to kind of sink in and get crepey on dry skin. It's just that perfect in-between natural formula. And I really also like it because let's say someone just wants like a sheer wash of color, you could do that. Or if someone wants this to be built up to like an intense under eye concealer, I've done that as well with this concealer. So if you guys are not familiar with this exact concealer, this is the LA Girl HD High Definition Pro Concealer. I personally do not have all of the shades that it comes in, but again, I am working on expanding my kit. I have some deeper shades, dark cocoa, medium shades like cool tan, lighter shades like classic ivory, which that's one of the things that I need to do is definitely go lighter in this concealer. LA Girl has since expanded their shade range since I started using this concealer in my kit, so I'm definitely looking to pick up more of those. You can get these in a value pack on Amazon. I believe you can also get LA Girl concealer on Sally's Beauty, but please do not let the low price of these turn you away. Don't care about what other people say that you're using a cheap concealer in your kit, because I promise you guys, these are really great. A lot of the times I'll get a client who doesn't want foundation but wants a little bit of coverage. They want the under eye or the center of their face evened out. And this is a really great concealer for that. You can apply it almost like it's a foundation. It's just a little bit lighter and not as heavy in full coverage, if that makes any sense. I have this concealer palette by Morphe. This is their 10 color concealer palette, and I really do enjoy this palette. I would say that I like this the most for spot concealing on the face, just because this is a little bit more of a dry concealer. Of course, very reminiscent of like a potted formula. This is going to be better for like spot concealing on the face, stuff like that, because it is more of a dry formula to the touch, if you guys can see. But this has really nice coverage. I would say it's like a medium to buildable coverage. You can get it to be a full coverage concealer. This has been a really nice concealer palette for me. It does go pretty fair, but I do wish that it went deeper. I would say that's my only complaint with this Morphe palette, is that I wish there were some more like deep, rich shades in here. But I have gotten some decent use out of this. You could also use this as a cream contour on lighter to medium skin tones. Some of these shades make like beautiful cream bronzers. I've used this one to cream contour a little bit, cream highlighting. There's a lot of different things you guys can do with cream products, and it's really nice and also saves some money to really repurpose products. So I really like this one from Morphe. I would say this is one of the few things that I have left from Morphe in my whole entire makeup collection, and I do really love it in my kit. For eyebrows, I have these little e.l.f. eyebrow kits. I love these. These are such incredible quality. If you guys are not familiar with these kits, they are $4 a piece, and half of the kit is more of a creamy wax, and then the other half of the kit is a brow powder, which I think is essential. I personally, for me, have found that working with a brow powder is just the easiest on clients. I don't really love working with straight up pomades or pencils on clients, just because, I don't know, it's just my personal preference. If you guys are a makeup artist, then you'll know that some people just have preferences with like eyeliners, eyebrows, things like that. And eyebrow powders are just my personal preference when it comes to doing others' eyebrows. So these are only $4. Again, really nice quality. They last in the eyebrows a long time. I have three different shades. I have four. I cannot find the other one right now for the life of me, but I have these shades ash, medium, and dark, and it also comes in blonde, which I cannot find. Also really convenient, they do come with a little tiny brush if you guys are into that. I personally just use my own brush that I have in my brush rolls that I'll get into in a second, but these are really nice for the eyebrows, really affordable, really good quality. Like I said, my favorite favorite thing to use on my clients' brows. For powder and for setting my clients' faces, I have the original RCMA No Color Powder. I love this powder because, first of all, you get so much powder and it is so affordable. You get this whole thing of powder for $9 or $12, something like that. And this has lasted me a really, really long time. I've used this on a bunch of different clients, a variety of different skin tones, and I've never seen any flashback, any white cast or anything like that. It truly is just like a perfect universal powder. So that's a really, really great addition to my kit. This right here is the e.l.f. Daily Brush Cleaner, and this I do not use to deep clean my brushes, but if I have clients back to back and I need to clean my brushes really quickly in between uses and I don't have time to wash them, this is really great. It is going to take any excess color out of the brushes. This also will disinfect the brushes. It's just a really nice, quick clean, I guess you could say. It's not going to be an ideal deep cleaner by any means, but just a quick spray and wipe. This is a really nice one for that. It's not my favorite one I've ever used. My favorite one would be the Japanese brush cleaner. I will definitely have that link down below for you guys because that one is a lot better than the e.l.f. I just haven't been able to find the Japanese one at my local Ulta, so I picked up the e.l.f. one in the meantime. One essential item in my kit is a spray bottle of rubbing alcohol. Rubbing alcohol is going to be essential for helping you to disinfect your products. I typically, when I clean my products after, I spray this on and then I will wipe down the top layer with a tissue. The rubbing alcohol is a disinfectant. It is going to sterilize the product. And then in combination with rubbing down the top of any product with a tissue, it's just going to remove that top layer. So speaking of tissues, I just like to keep a little pack of Kleenex in my kit or maybe even some paper towels. But rubbing alcohol, I would say, is definitely, definitely key to get your products nice and disinfected for your next clients. Another staple in my kit is a mixing palette. This particular one is from the brand Crown Brushes. I really like this because although I always wash my hands when I do other people's makeup, I was in a habit of using the back of my hand for mixing stuff, for applying concealer and picking it up with my brush. I feel like this just comes off more professional to have a palette like this. It is going to ensure that it is sterilized. Again, I will wash and sterilize the palette in between clients, so I feel like it just comes off a bit more professional putting like liquids and creams and mixing them on here opposed to the back of your hand. It might just give your client a little bit more comfort seeing that you're using a sterile surface. But again, this is from the brand Crown Brushes. I believe this was like $2. I'm pretty sure you can get something like this on Amazon as well. I picked mine up at the Crown Brushes booth at the International Beauty Show in New York City. So those are all of my makeup artist staples in the front of my drawer. Now moving on to the back is where I keep my brushes and applicators. So for my brushes, my favorite brush roll for my kit is going to be from Crown Brushes again. I picked it up at that same beauty show. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, these ones aren't the cleanest right now because I did just have a client before I am filming this video. I really quickly just went ahead and did them with the e.l.f. spray, but after I finish filming, I am gonna go ahead and deep clean these brushes. So this is what the brush roll looks like. These are the array of brushes that you get in here. Again, this is from Crown Brushes and I love it. I believe this whole roll was about $25 to $30, which is not bad at all. Crown Brushes is a really great brand of brushes. So you have your face brushes, stipple brushes, foundation brushes, eye brushes, detail brushes, blending brushes. Two of these brushes I bought individually. I brought this one individually as well as this one just because I thought they would be really nice additions to the kit. But these are just such nice quality. I used to have a really not that great set from Amazon. I actually still have it back here. I will show you guys what these look like if I could get it out, but I definitely don't recommend these. I purchased these because the whole set was like $10 and I thought it was such a steal, but honestly the quality just really shows in here. It's not the greatest quality. So I don't know how well you guys will be able to see all the brushes in this roll. You are getting a few more brushes than you do get in the Crown Brushes set. And like I said, this was cheaper. I thought that this was such a steal, but the bristles just aren't as nice. They're not as flexible. They're almost like a little bit too plasticky and synthetic. And don't get me wrong, I definitely don't mind using synthetic brushes, but these ones were just a little bit too plasticky. So even though this might seem like a really great deal, they just weren't the best quality. I definitely would recommend spending a little bit more than like $10 on your brush roll. And that is why I really do love this one a lot from Crown Brushes. So if I could find this, I will link this one down below for you guys. And of course, I'm sure you guys have seen a brush roll before. It just rolls up into this really nice, convenient roll. It protects the brushes. It keeps them nice and clean when you travel. And the last thing that I keep in this drawer are disposable applicators. These are so beyond important, you guys, if you are trying to build your makeup kit, just because, of course, you cannot use the same mascara on someone, the same lip wand, stuff like that is just not sanitary at all. And these disposable applicators are really not that expensive. Right here, I have a ton, like a ton of mascara wands. I believe that this pack has like 200 or 300 mascara wands or even more of them. And I got all of these for $5.99, something like that on Amazon. They are so affordable, but when I tell you guys, these are probably the most important things to keep in your kit. Just for sanitary reasons, you guys know you shouldn't share your mascara with anyone. You do not want to be reusing the same wand on a bunch of different people. And you cannot even re-dip a mascara wand back into the tube. So that's why I'm saying it's important to have a lot of them, because you might use one wand, apply mascara, and then you throw it out, you use another wand, dip it into the tube, and go over with a second layer, if that makes any sense. So these disposable wands, you only dip into the tube one time, so I might go through like four of them on each eye, so maybe eight mascara wands per client, something like that. So I definitely would recommend having a ton of them. So the packaging on these just broke, so I'm sorry about that. But the next type of applicators that I wanna share with you guys are lip wands. These are really great for lipsticks, liquid lipstick, lip glosses. Again, the same thing with the mascara wands. These are just meant for like one dip into any tube and then they get disposed. So I'll just take one out of here to show you guys. Not only are these going to be the most sanitary way to apply lipstick, but I also feel when it comes to applying lip products on other people, this just overall helps me to be more precise because I could really have just like a better hold on it. I can kind of grip it up higher and not worry about holding a wand that's like full of product. And then the last applicators that I want to share with you guys are these little spatulas. I picked these up for $1 at the Crown Brushes booth at the International Beauty Show. I really love these spatulas the most for mixing product or scraping product out of a pot. A lot of the times I will use this spatula to take some of the concealer out of this palette if I could get it open. So like, let's say I wanna use like a little bit of this concealer and then use a little bit of this one, let's just say for instance, I will scrape it off with this spatula and then I will put it actually on the mixing plate and that's where this comes in and I will just use it and mix it on here. Again, just another little disposable tool to keep things sanitary. It is very multi-purpose. You could use it to mix stuff, take stuff out of pots. If you are like me and you have long acrylic nails and it's hard to like reach in a pot and grab product with your finger, this is going to help you a lot. So I believe that is the last disposable product that I have to show you guys, but I cannot stress enough how important these are. The lip wands, the mascara applicators, and the spatulas. I would say the lip wands and the mascara applicators are definitely going to be the most important and the most crucial to keep everything nice and sanitary in your kit. All right, you guys, so that is going to complete this video all about what is on my makeup artist kit, kind of how I grew my makeup artist kit on a budget. Keep in mind, like I said earlier, that these are just kind of like my staples and like my essentials. I really recommend all of these products. I really don't think that you have to have all of the Fenty foundations and the Dior mascaras and the Tom Ford lipsticks to be a great makeup artist. All it takes to be a great makeup artist is passion, practice, and creativity, and just a drive and a love for what you do. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed seeing this video and found it helpful. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps me out. Also, make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel before you leave. I would love to have you guys here as part of my little YouTube fam. You guys are definitely going to want to subscribe because right under my makeup artist drawer is my giveaway drawer for when I hit 10K, and that drawer is getting pretty full. Let's just put it at that. So definitely make sure to subscribe if you guys aren't already. If you don't want to miss out on any of my future videos, click that notification bell down below and you'll get notified every single time that I upload a new video. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and of course, I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys.